much. Can't believe we lost.
This is a blow, right? At least we've got heaps of homework to take our minds off it.
Oh no! I bring me out my scummage!
Oh my goodness, Bianca. We just lost our tennis match. Who cares about your nail?
It's all the negative energy around it at the moment.
There does seem to be something wrong. Where are everyone's pity values? No one cheered for our team. There was no excitement, and we players were as limp as we're paper out there.
Is paper mache?
We're paper is paper mache, silly.
Here you so stop that, you'll wear us out again. I wish we still had our uniqueness ready still.
But don't you feel it? There's something definitely blocking my vibrations.
But now that you mention it, I couldn't even get inside over the gloss test yesterday.
And I didn't know the capital Australia was in the Kahoot quiz.
And the small person tried my choir presentation this morning.
Oh my gosh, you guys, you won't believe what I just found.
Cool. Take five deep breaths. And tell us what all this fuss is about.
Oh well, the vital is not just a text, that is not kind.
Where did you get this, Paul?
It was stuck to the door in the cloak bay.
From the desk of Hilgrim, Queen Fair of all dark deeds, of bountiful beauty and bossiness. Sculpture of scorps and squibs, most highly rude of all things monstrous.
Well, she sounds like a fun girl.
To the pure-hearted students of Waitakere School.
Oh yes, yes, that's us, all right.
You probably would have noticed that your purity values have been missing of late.
No kidding. There's been no respect, no initiative, or responsibility.
I require your services for a small task, the payment of which will be the safe return of your purity values. She's holding our purity values for ransom.
Told you it was far out, man.
She's a very, very not nice person.
Totally.
Well, gracious, does she say what this task is?
There's more. She says, if you ever want to see the return of your purity values, go to the purity tree. There you'll find a mushroom ring. I look forward to our meeting and our successful mutual association. Yours, Hilgrim, Queen Fair of all dark deeds, etc., etc.
Mushroom ring?
A fairy ring. Did you know that legend has it, if you step across a fairy ring, you end up in fairy land, so they speak.
Okay, right, come on now.
Oh yes, it's happened to me before. Fairy ring doorway.
True, you didn't need any mushrooms, did you?
Okay, seriously now, doorway or not, it's rented time and we aren't allowed around the back.
Well, I don't know about all of this, but I do know that our purity values have gone missing. And today's tennis match showed me that. I'm willing to do about anything to get them back.
Are you suggesting we go like traipsing around the bush by the purity tree?
Ugh, I can feel the cosmic forces. Definitely have to go to fairyland, yes.
Oh, there you have it, we're going on a road trip.
What about you, Bianca? You gonna go?
Well, if you all are going, I suppose I could put my red bands on and just give me a sec so I can check my hair.
Oh, I just know I'm gonna regret this.
Thank you. values, stick it in a bottle, and make them run if you said.
Oh, but it did work. Great one, it did.
Beyond their way magnificence, the mushroom fairies are bringing them.
Ah, there they are. Belinda, bring them to me.
Welcome to the court of Hildebrand, Queen Fairy of all dark deeds, of bountiful beauty and bossiness, sculpture of squabs and script, and blah, blah, blah. For your own safety, we recommend you read the rule book carefully and confine yourselves to the areas marked visitors only. Make sure that you scan, use sanitizer, and sign before you leave. Thank you.
Are you sure these are the right ones? Some of them look a little skinny.
Why, thank you!
We assure you, these children, your carefully chosen magical one.
What do you mean, this and that character? We sure are pure-hearted.
And we're here about your little. We demand our pretty baby that. If it's not too much trouble.
Oh my goodness, what a terrible hostess I am not to have offered you some refreshments after your long journey. Kindly help yourself to some gooseberry juice and do try a slice of my fairy cake, the best in the land.
Stop!
Dan, you gave me a fright.
Don't you know you can't eat?
Why not?
Dad, do you know how many calories are in that fairy cake?
No, this food's enchanted. If you eat it, you have to stay here. You can't leave.
That's ridiculous.
Then why do you think they want us to eat? Because they're nice.
Thank you for your hospitality. We really just want our Perdido babies back, please.
Ah, down to business then. See this bottle? This bottle contains all your precious Perdido values. You'll get it back as soon as you can complete a task for me.
Cool, bring it on, sister.
I need you to get me something from the mixed up world of fairy tales.
What is it and how do we find this?
Sounded so good.
I just knew it.
Since the message is for us, don't you think we should know what it is?
Hildegrim, Queen Fairy of all dark deeds, or bountiful.
Yes, we know.
Well, she says that there was a task that the pure-hearted ones need to complete.
I just knew it.
You need to get a mirror, former, a kelpie.
Oh no, they're doomed!
It's too horrible to even think about.
Well, what's so horrible to even think about?
What's a kelpie? A dog?
No, not a dog. Not at all.
More like a horse, actually, don't you think?
Yes, yes. Like an insect. And we know anything about a horse.
Oh, yes, yes, yes. A sweet little pony. I can ride, you know?
No, you mustn't ride them.
Frighten horses, these are.
Oh, the stories I have heard.
People flock into the waves.
And torn to pieces by sharp horse teeth.
But horses don't have sharp teeth.
Have you ever been bitten by a horse?
No.
Then how do you know how sharp their teeth are?
Okay, back up everyone, let me get this straight. Peregrin wants to find some kelpies and get a mirror of them. Why?
Because kelpie mirrors foretell the future.
Peregrin wants to see the future, I can do that for her.
This is crazy. So we get the mirror, who's to say she won't make us get another thing, and another thing again, and we'll never get our Peregrin values back.
We don't have a choice. All we can do is follow up. I say we keep our eyes and ears open. There has to be a way to help her. Dan, what else can you tell us about kelpies?
Well, we'll probably want to do our negotiations with a female kelpie.
Why?
She'll probably be less likely to kill us.
Good enough reason for me. Which way do we go?
Oh, at last, something Dan doesn't know.
Well, I know if I can try and look.
I can play my flute.
Oh, did you know that kelpies are very vain, especially about their hooves? Maybe one of us is something that could interest them. Oh, Bea, can you...
Don't you even think about it!
A mysterious and beautiful kelpie. What can we offer you for the mirror? Name it.
The mirror cannot be bought.
Not even for these.
Deal.
Huh? But you said the mirror cannot.
I like your boots. Red bands, aren't they? Come on, Bianca, give them up. It's for a good cause.
Hey guys, wait. Haven't any of you actually wondered what she wants the mirror for?
I like Sona. It's all here in the mirror.
Give her your magic in the mirror.
For once, Peter's right. Have a look for yourself.
Yo, check it out. It's Hildegard.
And she's got it there. Then we show her a way to a book.
Oh, look, the key opens it.
What is she doing with the book? Is she actually writing in it?
Look, she's changing all the endings to all the story. She's got the wolf blowing up a tornado and frightening three little pigs as houses and eating them.
Oh goodness, and here the princess just totally getting tangled in that thorny old hedge around the castle, and poor old Sleeping Beauty never gets woken up. No kids.
We can't let Hildegard change all the stories.
Come on. We're going back to Hildegard's castle.
To what exactly?
Don't know yet. Come on, just sorry.
dangling head first over Draylor's fiery chasm. That silly dragon has been plaguing me for weeks about his ulcer. The alchemist has prescribed a change in diet. You three would do perfectly.
Yes, Your Majesty.
Are very influenced by the music of the flute and whistle, and are also known to
Odin.
What do we do next?
We grab the Piddly values and get out of here.
No, we can't leave fairy tale lands in the hands of Pilgrim. Imagine all those wonderful stories all messed up. What if you have kids one day? I'm not going to be the one to tell them that, the prince could save Snow White's life by giving her CPR, but instead he got lost in the Seven Dwarfs' mind because we were in too much of a hurry to get our Pudding Willies back. Wow, where did that come from?
Penny's right. We've got to fix things here now. Otherwise, Helgen will just try again.
Pure, get the key. Penny, grab the PDAs, the anchor, the mirror.
So the plan is...
Maybe you have to tell what you want.
Okay, mirror, mirror.
On the wall, who's fairest of them all?
Mirror, mirror, where's to find the book of fairy tales?
Those beards are so cool.
Hey, what's this?
Let's see. The five pure-hearted students were surprised to find themselves in a large, elaborate room, surrounded by the sweetest smell of fairy cakes and fairies. Guys, it's us!
You have to be kidding me! Our story's in here too?
But suddenly, there's no ending.
Because we have to write it. We have to write the finishing to our story.
That's it. We can write an ending that saves Fairy Tale Land and gets its own, but what shall we write?
How about that pool cool kicked Kildarum's bush?
How about Dan managing to steal Hildarum's wand from her pocket?
Good one, Beanfus.
Hey, isn't this Kildarum's very own wand?
Oh, it's working so well.
Meanwhile.
Oh, how about spell? We'll need to rhyme. Did you know that spells always rhyme?
Ashes to ashes and dust to dust, Hildegard will start to grow a huge bust.
Be serious, Fiona. I don't know what good that would do.
Well, you try and think of something that rhymes. It's not easy, you know.
For all the evil she has dealt, Hildegard will start to melt.
No, that's not kind, even for Hildegard. By the light of the shining sun, all evil dark deeds must be undone. Our school is very dear to us, and must have the pretty values that is clear. To deal now for the evil one, I feel we deserve a little fun. So Hildegard will leave her home and our first school's garden.
So well out there, Gabby. Everyone was watching.
Now I can barely think of my homework. Good vibrations everywhere.
Except with me! My new hands have like totally vanished!
For goodness sake, Bianca, you probably have them on the field. We
Don't you get it? It's like we've done this before.
Yo, you guys, check it out. I found a garden gnome in the fairy garden.
Oh. Oh, garden gnome. Did you know that garden gnome was first?
Oh, Dan. Guys, where are your pretty values? Respect? I wonder who it is.
Maybe it's five dibs.
Maybe it is. We better put it back.
Thanks for my cheating, girl.
Thank you. Thank you.
doesn't work.
You've worked too hard for this not to work. Okay.
Yes.
Well, it's okay.
Yeah.
This is an amazing invention. Eva's invented these all herself. And it's worked.
I need to get one.
There we go. to learn. And you need to have some IT skills because we're learning online. We learn on the computer. These guys learn alongside students from all around New Zealand on the computer. So first of all, I will give out these certificates. So congratulations, Ruby, for your work on visual arts. To Mr. Tokerider-Jones, who I have the privilege of teaching the design, and who is a fantastic designer. To Zara, with your visual arts. Fantastic. To Luca, for Espanol. Muy bueno. To Ivan, también, muy bueno. In Spanish?
Gracias.
No, de nada. To Zion for Digitech. Got to have said robots, so I'll just say congratulations. To Eve with Japanese. To Sophie for Japanese. To Annie for Japanese.
And to Sam for visual arts, and it's sitting on my desk. Sam, oh. Come forward and say, honey. I realised as you got to the end. Sorry, he wasn't visual sitting arts. On my desk waiting for you. I'll give it to you a little bit later.
And then we have a few other certificates here, who these guys participated, but in their classes, your e-teacher will pick out one, possibly two people from a class that have really stood out for their mahi. So we have here in visual arts, Caitlin, for diligently working to complete her art and developing further in response to feedback. So, karawi. And we have a special award for Lewis. Thank you for consistently contributing in class discussions and helping others with recommendations and feedback. And that's from Lucy. Well done, Lewis. And for Espanol, we have Layla for always being willing to participate in class and giving it a go. Fantastic. Now, of our special awards, of the hundreds that we have around the country, one aponga is picked out of the draw, and this year it was one of the students from Waitariki. And the prize draw for that is a brand new Chromebook. Now, the student doesn't know she got a special award.
This has been the hardest secret ever.
So one of the students, who I haven't given a special award to today, but she did get one, is... Can I have a drum roll on the ground, please?
Hi everyone, I would like to take this opportunity to talk to each and every one of you about how Waitariki School has helped me grow as a person. When I first came to Waitariki in 2018, I was coming from a school all the way in Auckland with about 700 to 800 kids in it. This school, on the other hand, at the time only had about 19 to 22 kids. It was a huge change for me. This school made me nervous because I thought maybe the chances of being bullied were higher because the school was small. But that was definitely not the case. Everyone was so kind and welcoming. I was pretty quiet in my first week at school, but I got comfortable so fast that I started enjoying school. I had never felt like this about school before. In fact, I've always hated school, and this school made me feel like I belonged. I have had some pretty good memories over the course of 4 years at Waitaki, but two that have really stood out for me are Ripper Rugby and soccer, which have really engaged me into outdoor activity. It has made me feel stronger and fitter, which has helped me keep healthy and happy. And senior camp last year was amazing. Though it was only 3 days long, everyone had a great time, and it was probably one of my favorite things to do here. It has also helped me feel more confident and like I can be myself. I've learned a lot in the course of 4 years, but I've really improved my maths since my first year here. When I first started, I was below level for my age, but I think that I've really extended my learning since then. I've also learned that I can do whatever I set my mind to. Having people such as friends and teachers to support me has improved my confidence, and I feel safe and comforted. I hope that in high school I can make new friends, extend myself in sporting activities, and excel my education. I'd like to thank the people that have helped me through my journey at Waitariki, including teachers, students, and anyone else who has helped me. Firstly, a huge thank you to my friends for always being there when times were hard or difficult. I don't think I would have survived school without you guys. You're the best. My teachers, I would like to thank for teaching me everything I've learned over the duration of 4 years. Thank you, Fai Jo, for helping me with reading things more fluently and with a great understanding. I've also never felt so passionate to read books until now when you recommended Hatchet. Thank you, Fai Deep and Fai Beck, for helping me with writing and grammar. You guys have taught me so much, and I really appreciate everything I've learned from you guys. It has even helped with the speech. Thank you, Fai Bronnie, for helping my brain in the morning with daily maintenance. I've since gotten into a good math level for my age. Also, thank you for the opportunity this year to do our sporting activities. It has really been a game changer for the way I look at sport. Thank you to Fai and Natalie, Mrs. Cameron, and Mrs. Downer for helping anyone who's in need. You are kind and show initiative all the time. You have been so helpful, and sometimes you are the best people to go to if ever a problem. Thank you, Mrs. George, who has always been welcoming and supportive. I'd like to give her credit for our Pururi values, because when she was younger, she planted the Pururi tree, which now gets commonly used as our Pururi values, keeping our school a calm place to be. And lastly, thank you, Ms. Jones, for being a great role model and excellent leader. You have helped me in maths when you were teaching, and also improved my writing skills. Since then, you have stepped up to be a full-time principal, but still have the same great personality. In the future, I hope to enjoy high school as much as I did at Waitariki. I wish Waitariki School a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
My That was a wonderful speech. Really well done. And actually, quite touching, I think. Key thing for me is it's kind of what we want to achieve from the school and even from the board perspective, is for you to come and want to love to learn, and for you to have taken that one thing away at least is so amazing. And I think that's really great. So there's just a little gift here, a little bit of a book. Don't know whether you've read this one, but Dr. Zeus, Oh, the Places You'll Go. It's a bit of a favourite of mine. Maybe this one here. You know, you've brains in your head, you have feet in your shoes, you can steer yourself any direction you choose. It's really, really cool. And the teachers have all written a nice little note in here for you, so to sort of wish you on your way. So thank you for your participation in the school and everything that you've done and to help out the school and I think the rest of the kids and stuff as well. So thank you. Kia ora koutou. Wairakei students, families, school staff, board members, and members of the Wairakei community, thank you all for your support throughout the challenging year that has been 2021. It truly is a shame that we can't all be here together in person to share in the celebration of the end of the school year, but we still thought it was really important to be able to share this video with you today. Congratulations to all of the kids that have put in a massive effort into their performances that they've done today. It is so great to see so many kids taking up the opportunity to stretch their individual boundaries. The creativity and talent demonstrated today makes us extremely proud to be part of the Wairakei school and community. As we're approaching the end of the school year, I would like to take this opportunity to say thanks to a few people. Firstly, to our parents, families, friends, and members of the Wairakei community, the board values your support you provide to the students and the school. We have a special school, and it is important for us to work in harmony to help the students achieve the best of their abilities. Thank you to all of those who have helped out during the year, from helping during school hours, helping with transport, fundraising, and working bees. Everyone's help is greatly appreciated and helps to reinforce the wonderful atmosphere of the Wairakei school. To my fellow board members, Tanya, Larissa, Jane, Deb, Laurie, Alethea, and Teresa, thank you for your time and efforts for 2021. It's great to work with a supportive team working together to achieve the best for our kids' educational achievement. And thank you to the teachers and support staff, Fire Joe, Bronnie, Deb, Carol, Lisa, Natalie, Bex, Alethea, Paul, and Helena. We appreciate the dedication, hard work, and passion you bring to your roles that help support our children to have a safe, fun, and challenging learning experience. Thank you for your resilience, your initiative, and your flexibility that has been incredibly important to help our children navigate what's been another challenging year. And a massive thank you to Teresa. This year has thrown up many more challenges on so many levels. Teresa has stepped up to all of these challenges and has provided, and I think we've been exceptionally lucky to have your leadership skills to help us navigate through the year. From a board perspective, we've continued to implement our school charter or our strategic plan. Again, it's been a challenging year, and there's quite a few things we're going to roll over for the next year, for 2022, as we look to cement in the direction that we're going with our school. On the property front, from the board perspective, we've finally ticked off a few significant milestones. One of those in particular was the Bag Bay roofing completion. Probably another big milestone this year was getting the new courts resurfaced, which has been great. We've completed our 10-year property planning exercise, and part of that, there's a number of property projects in the pipeline for the school, which include re-roofing of many of the school buildings, addition of an indoor-outdoor learning space, and fingers crossed we'll work towards getting an upgrade to the administration area. From a financial perspective, things are progressing well and we look on track to achieve our spending within the 2021 budget. We've drafted the budget for 2022 and should approve this at our next board meeting. We're looking forward to the next year at Wairakei, where our kids will come for fun, vibrant and exciting learning. We look forward to continuing to build on our parent and community support. Have a safe Christmas and New Year. Enjoy the time off, recharge your batteries, and we'll see you all in 2022. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Jason, for your kind words. It really is humbling to work with such an amazing supportive team of people in the Wairakei community. And that is everyone who you mentioned from within the school, within the community, our parents and definitely our children. This is a great time for us at the end of the year to come together and celebrate what we've achieved over the 2020-2021 school year. And actually we have a lot to celebrate this year. Our fantastic students and staff who'd carried on teaching and learning, putting 100% effort into everything they do at school, regardless of what's happening in the outside world. Without a doubt, this year has had its challenges. We've missed our parents on site and the important depth of communication that brings to the students' education. The Kaiako have tried to compensate for this with extra Aduka stories, detailed emails, texts, messages and Facebook posts. We really appreciate those of you who have read these communications carefully and have shown appreciation for the huge effort and increased workload that our dedicated teachers have taken on. Often it is their own families who miss out while the teachers endeavour to provide the best education they can for your children. They definitely appreciate the support and being shown appreciation occasionally. For example, it was a wonderful surprise for Fire Jo yesterday when she sent out the big day in notice and almost instantly received five replies, and all of them were supportive. It was a great way for Jo to end the school year. This year we've farewelled two lovely students who've moved house and transferred to Norfolk School, and we've welcomed in 15 new students into the Wairakei School whānau. I was showing a prospective family around earlier this week and we were standing outside watching our students playing before school. And this family commented that it looked like we were one big happy family. I'm super proud of the way that our students live, think, feel, speak and breathe the Purere values. Perseverance, uniqueness, respect, initiative, responsibility and integrity really do underlie everything we do here at Wairakei. When they walk in through the school gates, our students know that they are entering a safe place where their strengths are celebrated and their needs are supported. Most of our students have made excellent academic and social progress this year. Many have stepped up to take on leadership roles and develop new initiatives around the school. We have a new bike track under development, bush planting, tennis and handball championships at lunchtime. We've had Kiwis named, amazing art completed, and we've even sold some to buy a slide. The kids raised $762.50, which is a huge achievement and will buy them a fantastic slide. Our students' successful year is topped off by their performances, again organised in a way that we could include as many of our school whānau as possible. Thank you to everyone who has supported Wairakei School in any way this year. Without you, we wouldn't be the school that we are. Merry Christmas, everyone, and we'll see you in 2022.